Hi friends, this is Nagajyoti, St. Peter's Engineering College. So in this session, I want to discuss about integrating type of ADC and specifications of ADC and DAC. As we know that the example for integrating type of ADC is nothing but dual slope ADC. So let us start with dual slope ADC. So this is a block schematic of dual slope ADC. So if we observe the block schematic, it consists of A1, A2, comparator, control logic and end stage counter. So as it consists of two op amps, it is called as dual. So it is also called as dual ramp converter. Here A1 represents high input impedance buffer and A2 is an integrated circuit, and the A2 is followed by a voltage comparator. So in this, the converter first integrates analog signal for fixed duration, that is for 2 power n clock periods. So depending upon the n stage counter, that many number of clock pulses will be converted by using an integrator. After integrating analog input signal of 2n clock periods, then it integrates an internal reference voltage of opposite polarity. That is, if analog signal is of positive, then reference voltage should be of negative level. So this integration will be continued until the output is equivalent to zero, and the number of clock cycles required in order to get output of an integrator is proportional to the analog voltage. So if we observe this circuit, here before A1 we are having a switch SW1, and at A2 we are having a switch SW2, and for the control logic we are having one input which is nothing but start, and two outputs. One output is given to the end stage counter and the other output is EOC. So here EOC stands for end of conversion. Now let us start how this dual slope ADC is going to be used in order to convert an analog signal into a digital signal. Before the start signal is applied, this switch SW1 is connected towards the ground and SW2 switch is closed. And whenever we are giving a start signal, that is, if we see this 0 to T1 represents, it is auto 0 mode, and here T1 represents we are going to operate this start operation. So here whenever switch is started, that is at arrival of switch at start position, this T will be at T1 position, and control logic opens SW2 and connects SW1, that is first switch position, to an analog signal. So whenever this switch position is connected to the analog signal, the counter will start counting from the initial value, that is 0, to the maximum value. So whenever the counter reaches to maximum value, that is after 2 power n clock cycles. So let me take a counter is a 4 bit counter. So it will count the maximum number of clock pulses is nothing but 16 clock pulses, that is 2 power 4, 16 clock pulses starting from 4 zeros to 4 ones. So whenever at T equal to T1, counter will automatically start counting from initial value to the final value, that is total number of clock pulses it will count is 2 power n. That is the reason here they have represented from T1 to T2, the number of clock pulses it is counting is nothing but 2 power n. Then VA, that is analog signal, is integrated for a fixed duration. What is this duration? Is nothing but the number of clock pulses, that is 2 power n clock pulses. Till that clock pulses, this analog signal is going to be integrated, and after 2n clock pulses, it is automatically reset to the zero value. If clock period is T, then integration takes place for a time, that is T1 equal to 2 power n into T, and output is negative ramp, because as we know that the integrator, if the input for the integrator is a positive step signal, the output of an integrator is a negative signal. That is the reason the output of this will be a negative ramp starting from T1 till towards the T2. So whenever the counter resets to zero, that itself indicates the T1 interval has been completed with a negative reference slope. Now, and if we observe that at the switch SW1, we are having other more position, that is the switch position is having two positions. One is connected to either to a VA, or either it is connected to a VA or it is connected to the negative reference. As we have seen that for VA, then it is connected towards the negative reference. As we just now we seen that whenever the input is positive, the output of an integrator is negative. As I am giving here negative reference supply, the output will be a positive. Then this will be passed through a comparator circuit, and it will give an output to a control logic, which allows the clock pulses to be counted. That is, in between T2 to T3, it will integrate a negative reference voltage. So whenever the output of a comparator, which is nothing but V0, is 0, when this will be 0 is nothing but a T equal to T3. That itself indicates that our analog signal has been converted into a digital signal. So the control logic will give an output command EOC as high. That itself indicates the conversion has been completed by giving a signal. EOC represents end of conversion. So no further clock pulses will be going to be entered into the counter. So here the time T3 will represent the proportionality of the analog signal. So here T1 represents the difference between T2 and T1. So in between T2 and T1, it will integrate an unknown signal, and it will integrate the time is nothing but 2 power n counts and divided by that clock rate. Similarly, we can write down the expression for an integrator. Integrator is nothing but integral of input signal. So here V1 is equivalent to minus 1 by RC into VA T2 minus T1. Similarly, we can write down the expression for V2, and we can derive the expression in terms of the unknown voltage with respect to that of the reference voltage, as well as the number of clock pulses. So the final expression is nothing but VA equal to VR into N by 2 power N. Similarly, if we observe the previous thing, here T3, that is the time between T3 and T2 is nothing but it is integrating the negative reference voltage. So the time required in order to integrate the negative reference voltage should be equivalent to integration time required of unknown voltage signal. That represents you are calculating the unknown analog signal in terms of the negative reference signal. This is how you are converting your analog signal into a digital signal. And this is an example of an integrating type because we are not directly converting analog into digital, but this analog signal is converted in terms of time, and this time equivalent we are converting into a digital signal. So it is an example of integrating type ADC. Specifications of ADC and DAC. The first specification is resolution. So what is meant by resolution is, it is the smallest change in the voltage which may be produced at the output of a converter, or in simple words, it can also be seen as one LSB increment. Now, in order to understand the resolution, let me take an example of 8-bit D2A converter. So here, 8-bit itself indicates the bits are having 8. So the maximum count is nothing but 2 power 8, which is nothing but 256. So 2 power n minus 1. So 256 minus 1, which is equivalent to 255 equal intervals. So if there is a change in a single bit position, there will be change in the output as 1 by 255 of its full scale range. Similarly, it is also called as, if it is an 8-bit DAC, it is said to have 8-bit resolution. So resolution can be defined in two different ways, that is full scale deflection divided by 2 power n minus 1, or it represents the number of bits of a digital to analog converter. Similarly, for analog to digital converter, it is defined as the smallest change in the analog input for a 1-bit change in the output. So if you take an example of an 8-bit A to D converter, it is divided into 255 intervals. So if the reference is 10 ohms, then it is nothing but 10 divided by 255, which is nothing but 39.22 milliohms. Means the full scale voltage over here is 10 ohms. If there is change in the single bit position, there will be a differing of 39.22 milliohms. And the next is linearity. So the linearity of A to D or D to A converter is measure of its accuracy, and it tells how close the converter output is to its ideal characteristics. That itself indicates, if you take an example, the input of an analog signal is 3.3 volts, the output of a digital signal is ideally it should be 3.3 volts, but if we use a flash type ADC, instead of getting it as 3.3 volts, we will be getting the equivalent as 0.11, which is equivalent to 3. So ideal it should be of 3.3, but practically we are getting a 3 volts. So that itself indicates how much it is accurate with respect to that of the ideal characteristics and practical characteristics. And the third specification is glitches. This glitches will be particularly present only in case of digital to analog converter. And this is nothing but, it is a transition from one digital input to the next, that is if the corresponding bits of a digital to analog converter is 0111. So if this 0111, which is nothing but equivalent to 7, it need to change for the next most bit, that is 8. 8 equivalent is 1000. So whenever it is changing its bit position, it will take some time in order to change these positions, that is nothing but called as a glitches. And the next one is accuracy. Accuracy is the maximum deviation between the actual converter output and ideal converter output. So the difference between the ideal value and a practical value is nothing but accuracy. But whereas the meaning of a linearity is how much it is accurate is specified by the linearity. The next specification is monotonic. So here monotonic represents either there should be a continuous increase or a continuous change in a digital input. If a DAC has to be monotonic, the error should be plus or minus 1 by 2 LSB at each output level. And the next one is settling time. So the time taken for either DAC or ADC to settle to its final value is nothing but called as a settling time. So the maximum settling time of any converter is plus or minus half of that of LSB. And the last one is stability. The performance of a converter changes with temperature, age, power supply and variations. So the converter which we are using should be as stable as possible, means that it should not vary with temperature or by the usage. This is all about specifications for either A to D or D to A converter. Thank you.